Hi, today I would like to show you a couple of measurements with the latest of our high-speed arbitrary waveform generators. It's the M8196A. It's a 92 gigasample per second, 32 gigahertz arbitrary waveform generators, which has up to 4 differential channels in a single AXIE module. For my measurements today, I have it hooked up to both a real-time oscilloscope, that's one of our 63 gigahertz oscilloscopes, and I have it also hooked up another channel hooked up to the DCAX in order to show you some eye diagrams with PAM4 measurements. Now, before I start with PAM4, I wanted to kind of get to the point of why we're going to PAM4 in the first place, and that's really to get more data through in the same amount of bandwidth that's available on backplanes and other PC board material. So what you see right now is a 28 gigabit per second signal. It's an NRC signal, and you can see the corresponding spectral shape up there. It goes up to, takes spectral content up to about 50 gigahertz. Now the nice thing with PAM4 is when I change that to a PAM4 signal, and that's really a benefit of using an arbitrary waveform generator, you can just, by controlling a switch in the software, you can switch this over from NRC to PAM4. So if I load a PAM4 signal, you notice the spectrum doesn't actually change. It looks very much the same, except that now we're transmitting twice the amount of data over that same link within the same spectral content. And you can see the PAM4 signal at 28 gigabaud still looks very nice. So now we're transmitting 56 gigabits per second. Now, in order to go to the next step, I might want to play around with the bandwidth of this signal. That's, again, a big benefit of the AWG, because you can influence the shape of the eye that you're generating and thus influence the spectral behavior of your signal. So what if I want to get rid of that second lobe there? All I need to do is apply a pulse shaping filter with a raised cosine of 1, and let me show you what that looks like. So notice the bandwidth diagram up there. So the first lobe is still there, but the second one is pretty much gone. And if I clear the screen on the bottom one, we can see the signal looks more sinusoidal shaped, but this is very suitable still for 28 gigabaud transmission. What you can do to even further reduce the bandwidth, you can crank down this roll-off all the way to, say, a 0.1. I'm going to download that. You'll see now what happened is we cut our bandwidth in half once more. So now I'm only using 14 gigahertz of bandwidth. My signal looks a little different than what it would normally look like. But with proper phase tracking, this can be perfectly acquired. Now let's do the jump to the next speed grade and bring this up to 56 gigabaud PAM4. I'll bump up the baud rate and make this a 56 gigabaud. And I have to reset my time base here. Now you notice the spectral content increases again up to 28 gig, but now I have twice the data content. I have to actually go in to stretch the time base here on the scope so that we can see it. So now it's running at 56 gigabaud PAM4 or 112 gigabits per second. Now you might say the signal looks not quite the way you want it to be. So if you have enough bandwidth available, you can bring this back to a 1.0 and, you know, use up that available bandwidth. Now we're back to approximately the same bandwidth that we had before. It's about 50 gigahertz of analog bandwidth, but now we're transmitting 4 times the amount of data. Instead of 28 gig, now we're transmitting 112 gigabits per second. So let's take a look at that signal. And as you can see, the eyes are nice open and there's a little bit of noise on it, but for 56 gig signal, that is in quite good shape. So this is back to our 28 gigabaud signal. This is the clean signal. Now, once you get the clean signal, you can get started with adding distortions to that to see how your receiver might respond to that. So one of the things I wanted to briefly show you is, instead of the equidistant signal, you might want to experiment with adding pre-distortion to the signal in case you're driving an optical modulator. Using ARP technology, you can influence the levels of your PAM4 signal and generate signals like this. So if you're driving, if you have to drive an optical modulator that needs some pre-distortion, you can easily do that. The other aspect is actually a very powerful capability as well. If you have to go through a channel and you need to embed or de-embed that channel, you can take the S21, the S parameter of that channel, and just embed it on the signal. So let's go back to the nominal signal first. And then let's add a channel to that. So I have an S parameter file loaded here, and I will embed that S parameter file with the signal. So when I download that to the ARB, here is what the result looks like. So you can clearly see there's some amount of ISI now embedded into the signal. As the last measurement, I also wanted to show you some effect that some of the PAM4 signals have, and with this AWG, you can emulate those effects as well, and that is skewed eyes. So I will load my skewed eye setup, and I will show you that as well. At this point, you can see the eyes are artificially skewed, so the top eye is shifted to the right, and the bottom eye is shifted to the left relative to the center eye. So the eyes are shifted by approximately 2.5-3 picoseconds. That was a quick summary of the kind of capabilities you have with this new M8196A in conjunction with our high-speed real-time and sampling scopes. Thank you.